Well, we finally finished our table, but before we show it to you, let's recap and see how we got here.
We started our journey at a place called Community Forklift up in Maryland, where we found some pine that was at least 100 years old, taken from a torn down barn in the area. We loaded the boards up in Mark's truck, hey Mark, and then took it over to Tart Lumber, where it was planed and sanded into boards. Once we got our lumber home, we made a 7-foot-long, 30-inch-wide table. We glued the boards together and then biscuited the ends together. That's Callie in a monkey hat. Then it was off to Home Depot, where we picked up some wood conditioner, stain, and polyurethane. After we covered the table with one coat of stain, we filled the holes with cork so stuff couldn't fall through. After the second coat of stain, we filled those holes with a clear epoxy using one of Callie's syringes. Then we went back to Home Depot and picked up some pipe. This pipe is used for transporting oil and natural gas, but we're going to use it for legs. We found a really nice guy named Mike at Home Depot who cut the pieces and then put threads on them. Back home, we washed all the pipe, then screwed them together, making 2 H's. That's Callie asleep with a music box. We took those H's, connected them together with a long pipe. Then, after centering the pipe and leveling the pipes, we attached them to the table with wood screws, and then finally put felt on the feet so they wouldn't scratch our floors.
The finished product, it's nice and smooth. The table is over 100 years old, and hopefully it'll be here for another 100 years, and maybe Callie will have a dinner with her grandkids on this table. Do you like it, Callie? It's good, right?
To tell you the truth, it turned out a lot better than we expected. The stain and polyurethane really pulled out the character of this wood, and it has all the dings and dents that go along with being a 100-year-old piece of wood.
That's our table. Can't wait to have a meal with you on it. Bye!